rang out in a busy part of southern Davidson County.
Police tell us people inside two vehicles shot at each other, and a vehicle was also stolen from a nearby gas station. Now a manhunt is underway.
Let's get out to News Channel 5's Brandon Marshall, who is live in Antioch. And Brandon, I understand they have now identified a suspect.
Rory, that's correct. We just learned minutes ago that police are looking for 23-year-old Dion Woodruff. We have his mugshot, and we want to put that on your screen so you can take a good look at him. He is an accused murder suspect for a shooting back on May 1st at the Medusa Hookah Bar on Church Street. Police say Woodruff is also a suspect in today's shooting. This is what else we know. Woodruff and other people were in one SUV firing and ramming a second SUV along Bell Road. One SUV continued driving away, and Woodruff then got out of at this intersection. He ran to a nearby gas station and carjacked a woman. Right now, he is believed to be in a silver Chevrolet Malibu. Police also identified 21-year-old LaShawn Campbell as part of the shooting. Police tell us that Campbell is in Vanderbilt University Medical Center, and he's listed in critical condition right now because of the shooting. And there is a second victim in all of this, 22-year-old David Young. He is at Skyline Medical Center with serious injuries. Again, police are urging people in the area to be on the lookout for Woodruff. He is believed to be armed and dangerous, and again, riding in a silver Chevrolet Malibu. As this investigation continues, we want to let you know that Bell Road and Eagle View Boulevard is closed. And of course, as we learn any more information, we will update you guys on air as well as...
My second one.
Your second one. What was the first one?
I got my little brother YG name on my face, and he got killed.
Really? What was the situation around that?
He fucking... It's some inner city shit with motherfuckers he had been having problems with for fucking ever. And his stupid ass, I'm so mad at him to this day. It was just in the club, shit he don't do. Like shit he don't do, shit that our homeboys around him advised him not to be on, but he just was his type of nigga. He wasn't gonna do shit, he wasn't gonna do it.
What it do, YouTube, what the business is. And I just want to touch real quick and display the life, but more so the crazy life of a well-known, well-respected, well-loved rapper named YG MISTA. Now, rest in peace to YG MISTA. He was, unfortunately, gunned down of May 2nd, 2018 in his hometown of Nashville, Tennessee, while enjoying and celebrating life at a hookah bar. Now, it's crazy how he died, and I will get into that much more later in the story. Now, YG MISTA was a well-known Fruit Town Pyru who had rank within his stature, within his set. Now, he was from the east side of Nashville, Tennessee, from an infamous neighborhood that goes by the name of Lishy, or better known as Lishy Ave. Now, another infamous rapper that stems from that neighborhood goes by the name of Starlito. Now, it's clear to see that YG MISTA and Starlito both had different upbringings while being from the same neighborhood, although they are years and years apart. Now, YG MISTA had a serious rap feud with other rivals who so happened to be Crips from another side of town in the North Nashville area. Now, both of these guys came from heavily well-respected families and heavily well-respected backgrounds. In other words, their uncles, their pops, their moms, their dads, their big brothers, their big cousins were somebody. They put in work, they had this, they had that, they made this, they made that. Whether they passed away, got killed, whether they are incarcerated doing time for those things. But they were big guys, especially within those cities. And both of those people come from those type of families, especially YG MISTA's rivals. The Brick Man's babies, and as YG MISTA, you can somewhat say the same for him. Now, that rap rivalry stemmed off from numerous shootings, numerous murders. In fact, YG MISTA was questioned for numerous murders and numerous shootings. His name was brought up in numerous murders and numerous shootings. And with the respect that I have for his family, his loved ones, and those that are living within his side, I would not touch too deep on those. But let's just say that rap rivalry stemmed from videos being put out back and forth from their side, and so happened to catch up with him when he went out to a hookah bar one night. Now, this is where it gets crazy, and this is the true story, but the detailing is very, very horrific. Now, YG Mister was a tough guy. He was nothing to play with, and he felt that if you weren't on his level, or if you weren't moving how he was moving, he looked at you as a punk. Now, within the community guidelines of YouTube, I'm not going to say exactly what he said, but y'all will catch on to what I'm saying to what he said. Now, he walked up to a group of guys, and the first guy he walked up to, he nodded at him and said, "You a B." He went to the second guy and said, "You a B." He went to the third guy and said, "You a B." And when he got to the fourth guy, obviously he wasn't no B. Because before YG Mister could finish what he was about to say to him, that he had said to those previous guys, that guy took his gun out and gunned down YG Mister. And after that, he aimed his gun towards YG Mister's friends and started shooting them. And he shot one of them in the leg. Now, fast forward to after this, the police found out who the guy was who actually killed YG Mister. Now, he went on the run for all of this. Now, while him being on the run, now keep in mind, this guy was a killer. You know, this guy had beat 2-3 murders before this. You know, he was known for that, right? And I think he was already on the run for the murder. I could be wrong for that. But while on the run for the YG murder, YG Mister murder, he had stemmed in various and numerous shootouts within YG Mister's camp that stemmed went all over the city. One shootout stemmed from they had ran into each other on some random stuff, just so happened to be driving on the same street. Then they look over and the other car look over and it just so happened to be the same guys that they've been looking for. And they started shooting at each other with Dracos to the point where the same guy who got shot in his leg with YG Mister had got shot again in the leg with, this time, a Draco. Now, both of the cars are totaled and damaged. So, the guy who actually killed YG Mister and had shot at the same guy with a Draco this time had allegedly carjacked some people at a nearby gas station at gunpoint and took off with the car. Now, fast forward after that, more shootings had took place right after that. Now, 90 days or 30 days or 60, it was 30, 60 or 90 days exactly after the death of YG Mister. The same guy who had killed YG Mister was killed himself in a vehicle. Now, he was killed and backdoored by his friend. And one of the guys that had killed him or is locked up for doing it is one of the guys that is in YG Mister's camp. Now, it's crazy. It's crazy. Now, that guy was. And it's crazy how they did him like that, you know? Just imagine, you live by the gun, you die by the gun. That saying is true. Because, man, you gunned somebody down. You was on the run for a murder. You have beat previous murders. You know, you get allegedly set up by a guy who was in the camp of him, you know? And not only that, man, the guy who killed YG Mister and YG Mister, man, them guys are literally buried, like, 4 or 5 graveyards apart. This is true. They've been looking for each other this long. They hated each other this much to only be buried right next to each other. That's crazy. That's crazy. Now, YG Mister was signed to Sada Baby, right? Now, after the death of YG Mister, a lot of feuds took place. Like one feud who took place when 42 Doug aligned himself with the rivals of YG Mister, and YG Mister being aligned with Sada Baby. Now, this is after the death. And a lot of things did transpire after the death of YG Mister with the people of YG Mister's camp. Like an infamous rapper who was real close to YG Mister with his belongings being robbed and took. Now that led to a big war. A real, real big war with one of the biggest rappers, if not the biggest rapper in the game right now. Behind YG Mister's name. Now that's crazy. And I will touch a video on that, but rest in peace to all sides. Rest in peace to YG Mister. That was a crazy story of YG Mister.